Hello everyone, this is Dr. Ashfaq Ahmed and I'm working in the field of structure biology and bioinformatics. This is a short tutorial video about the compound property explorer in real time. What it means and how it is important or how much this topic is applicable. For example, you are performing some molecular docking or you are testing some compounds or drugs in your experiment and you want to know that what are the potent compounds. So for that you will perform docking analysis. Okay, we will cover the docking analysis in our next videos, but what about this topic? What kind of properties you need to explore? For example, if I asked you that the compound you docked in your experiment, is it toxic? And you will say, I don't know. If I ask you, is it mutagenic? Can make any mutations? You say, I don't know. And if I ask you, the compound you docked, is it tumorigenic? Can it cause tumor inside the body? And your answer, if it's again no, so this not a good thing. So how will you explore such kind of behavior of the compound which you are going to dock? So this video is actually important for your docking experiment, that you need to know that the compound I'm going to dock, is there any toxicity profile like tumorigenesis or any other profile or no. So it's a short video and we will do all these things in real time. And I'm sure that 90% of you, maybe they don't know about this kind of thing. So let's start. Here I will drop this link, I'll drop this link in the comment section of my video. So what you need to do, you need to just open this link and come here. I will drop this link. So upon once you click it, you will come here and you will need to download this. It's a smaller file, okay, and it will be downloaded into your download folder like I have, and its name will be Property Explorer. One thing you need to be sure that the icon will be like this. It's a Java icon. So if your system has a Java, you will see this icon once it is downloaded. If you don't have a Java, then please install Java into your computer. But I'm sure that almost 99% of the computers everyone has, it contains Java. Because it's a kind of essential thing, Oracle Java. So once you see this this icon, then okay, I clicked it. Once you click it, you will see this kind of thing. So remember, you don't need to install anything, just download that smaller file. It's almost 665 KB, almost half of MB. So you can download by using any kind of internet, that will not be a problem. Now for example, I'm testing this program on PubChem. You all know about PubChem or Zinc or any other database. If you have, that's okay. Okay, let me type, I'm going to type some name. Let's say I'm going to type Brofen. It's a name of a medicine, but it's also name of a compound. IV brufen, etc., and normally used as a painkiller. So okay, this is ibuprofen, and if you see here, for example, this is your compound, or could be any compound. Okay, so this is your compound, suppose, and from here you see here isomeric smileys, just copy and paste it here and click enter. Just wait for 10 seconds, and what do you see? You see just like traffic lights here. So the first four panels are toxicity risks, and the other six panels are somewhat related to the chemistry of ibuprofen. Okay, on the toxicity panel, it is mutagenic. So it means brufen is mutagenic. It can cause mutations. So on a lighter note, don't use brufen when you don't need it. Okay. It has reproductive effect. Is it tumorigenic? No. It is irritant. It means, can it cause any irritations to your body? No. But it has two problem. It retains two problem. It is mutagenic, and it has a reproductive effects. Now, how about C log P? We call it water partition coefficient. You need to study it. It's in, if the color is green, it means just like a traffic light, you can go. And if the color is yellow, orange. So orange means it's not bad, but also it's not bitter. Okay, so for example, C log P, it's okay. Solubility is okay. Molecular weight is okay. So molecular weight is okay. TPSA is okay. Drug likeness is okay. Drug score is, I would say, 30%. Or 31%, because it is 0.31. Okay, this is about this panel. Now, the beauty of this program, or if you want to use it further, so you can edit this compound. How? Look to this left panel. So for example, I'm going to bring some changes in it, and for example, I select this O, and I inserted a new bond here, so the drug score became increased, but the drug likeness became decreased. And interestingly, you see the toxicity risks are disappeared. Now, if I also want the drug likeness to be in green part, and also the drug score to be in green part, for example, I'm clicking here, let's say here, and this is eraser. I just clicked. Now I removed the hydroxyl group. Now the compound became irritant, and the drug likeness is, and the drug score, they are below par. So before it was OH, now let me try a single CH3. So now the drug likeness is good, drug score is good, but reproductive effect is still there. Let me insert sulfur. Now it has it has generated some problem. Now let's see, I inserted sulfur, and I also inserted CH3. So by it's you can say now it's the derivative of ibuprofen. It's not ibuprofen, because ibuprofen has a hydroxyl group here. Now the drug score is 80%, the drug likeness is 2.3, TPSA all green, and there were two toxicity risks, now they are gone. Okay, how to bring this kind of compound which you have edited into the in your docking. Then sometime I will make another video. You can use any program. One of them is the very famous program, ChemDraw. So you can take a picture of this or a screenshot and then draw it in your ChemDraw, and from there you can save it in 2D or 3D, whatever, or in a smileys, and then you can use it in your docking studies. So from this short video, I actually meant to tell you how can easily or in real time you can check properties of your compound you are going to dock. That's it for today, and now we are going I will going to start the docking very soon, and this is you can say the first video of from the docking series. So stay tuned, and if you like my videos, please support me, subscribe this channel, and also ask your friends to watch my videos. Okay, bye bye.